greetings. The majority of this video was prepared before the act of Islamic terrorism against the Orlando gay bar. If you see what is going on in the world and shake your head, you are not alone. But as you simply recount each and every topic, there is but one conclusion, and I'll get to that later. First, a personal example. Standing outside a store yesterday, I observed a squirrel crossing the parking lot. In comic book fashion, he stopped in the middle of the narrow lane. He sat up in that familiar squirrel pose. And then a minivan turned into the lot and barreled toward him. The minivan slowed. The squirrel hopped once and turned to face its threat. The minivan nose rose, then dipped as it threatened with a surge. Once again, the squirrel hopped once and turned to face its threat. That all you got? The minivan yet once more rose and dipped a threat. It might not stop again. And the squirrel, having faced death and earned entry into the squirrel gang, hopped across the grass island and sprang onto a tree. The minivan moved on and parked. I watched where, and as the driver approached the store, I wanted to share a moment of humanity and levity, so I said, "Quite a beast you faced down there." His answer abused my generous spirit of humanity. "Oh, I'll stop for them," he said. "But if it's a mom with kids in Trump shirts, I'm running them over." And then he left, as if that is the form of insanity he finds funny. I smiled to avoid any trigger words that might justify a fit of violence by the then recognizable subspecies of man, Liberalis moronicus. What form of insanity retards a human into thinking murder is funny. It is an insanity based on deception, and perhaps a facet of the strong delusion. But it is not just one issue or topic on which insanity is now ruling the day. It appears to be more and more approaching nearly all of them. Let us return to Liberalis moronicus for the moment. Visceral, conditioned hatred of Trump and any who might support him. If you are a member of Liberalis moronicus, your first retarded reflex will be to attack me as a racist. Yet I have not defended Mr. Trump in any way. "Yeah, but you didn't laugh at killing kids in Trump shirts." It is this retarded reflex of calling people racist that is crushing any hope of rational discussion. And only white people can be called racist. Ignoring the fact Islam is not a race. Ignoring the fact any skin color based prejudgment is prejudice. Ignoring the facts is part and parcel of the insanity. Destroying an ability to rationally discuss and debate is part of the insanity. Facebook's Orwellian crime of masking, hiding, and filtering conservative thinking. The IRS obstructing conservative groups because they are patriotic. If your agenda is globalism, you must impede, then persecute, then kill those who do not abandon national allegiances. Make no mistake, the killing is coming. Communist China, between 85 and 100 million people killed. Communist Russia, up to 61 million people killed. Abortionist America, over 56 million babies murdered. At least China and Russia had an agenda at a national level to kill those who opposed and threatened them. America has murdered 56 million for random, willy-nilly selfishness on a personal level. Soon, just referring to a woman's right to terminate an unwanted pregnancy as murder of a baby may be illegal hate speech. Referring to a man as a man when the man self-identifies as a woman or snail or poached egg will soon be criminal. And the Liberalis moronicus cannot grasp the mental process which might see this as a bad thing. This past week, at a commencement speech, Gigolo John Kerry declared,
"You're about to graduate into a complex and borderless world."
Borderless because governments of corrupt men have capitulated to evil globalism. If you do not get the picture, democracy is literally dead. That is not hyperbole. It is a realistic appraisal of the current global totalitarian government being pushed right now. The British people have seen the light, and their Brexit is their Trump moment.
Hell no, we won't go into slavery to your totalitarian one-world government.
Let me just list some of the logs on the bonfire of the insanities. Repeating the lie that Islam is a religion of peace. For 1400 years, Mohammedism has been spread by the sword. Making the nuclear deal with Persia assures they will obtain a nuclear bomb. Importing millions of uncredentialed young male Muslims, aka ISIS fighters. Europe thought, and may still think, every human wants socialist cradle-to-grave coddling. So they are importing millions and millions of ISIS fighters to work their factories. The rapes have only just begun until Europe submits to Chrislam. America is importing thousands of uncredentialed young male Muslims, aka ISIS fighters. This is literally the actions of one intentionally importing terrorism to American soil. I wrote the following the day before the Islamic terror attack in Orlando. I got chills when I heard the news on the television. And the truly ironic thing that will come of it is feminism and homosexuals will soon have their heads handed to them. And they will curse Christians and the God of the Christians, and not Islam or the Allah of Islam. The first retort from Liberalis Moronicus will be that the Muslim murderer was not from Syria, but was born in America. And there really is only one word needed to identify the murderer's genesis. Islam. Refusing to enforce border laws. It makes sense a globalist would do this. It is still evil in the truest sense of the word. Ripping the anchor of gender and normalcy from a whole generation. Is child abuse worse than just murdering them in the womb? Nothing in the animal world is gender confused. Mutilating and surgically deforming a confused child is evil. Dr. Mengele must be clapping and laughing and cheering in hell. Safe spaces and thought police. College campuses turned into mental death camps. Intentionally killing the thinking processes of the next generation. Why else would anyone vote for their own slavery and doom? Free speech zones. The only place where contrary, meaning normal, right, and logical, thinking is soon to be allowed in America. Calling people racist to attack them and shut them up. The real problem is cultural, and the only solution must involve reality. Okay, it is more than just cultural. It is spiritual and has all been forewarned. The spiritual darkness drives the cultural evil. The conditioned reflex of calling people racist is part of the programming, the conditioning, and the thought control. It has an exact parallel in Islamic conditioning and programming. In Islam, the conditioned reflex of calling people liars is part of the conditioning and the thought control. People have been conditioned or inoculated against rational thinking. In the case of Liberalis Moronicus, their conditioning hinges on them thinking they think. It creates in them the arrogant presumption that they have the right answer, aka their conditioning. It is how they can think and claim they are tolerant and then joke about murdering someone in a Trump shirt. I suspect this bonfire of the insanities is one facet of the strong delusion. Humanity is being intentionally stupefied and retarded so that the globalists have an easier conquest. But the globalists, while scheming and driven, do not really understand the flow and purpose of history. They think a one-world government is their idea, and their scheming, which is anti-Christian, will make them totally vulnerable to the deceptions of Islam, and soon, Chrislam. Hold fast to the truth that Jesus is Lord and that God raised Jesus from the dead. The forced changes are happening faster than could be imagined, and all the pieces are in place, and the springs wound tight. When things happen, they will happen fast, and those unprepared will not see it coming. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.